Well, whatever it is you think you need, you better grab it fast. Yonder stands your orphan with his gun, crying like a fire in the sun. Look out! And it's all over now, baby blue. The highway is for gamblers, you better use your sense. Take whatever you've gathered up from coincidence. The empty-handed painter from your street is drawing crazy patterns on your sheets. The sky too now is folding up on you, and it's all over now, baby blue. Your lover who just walked out your door has taken all his blankets from the floor. The carpet too is moving under you, and it's all over now, baby blue.
Welcome to Mudding with Beagz. This is episode 46. Hope you all are doing well this week. I've been doing late night live streams with Boston Ray on the Boston Ray Mudflood Adventures channel. And also, he's also aka Michelle L. And we've also had Bill Miller from Bill Miller Flip channel. And we've had others joining in nightly, and we've been going for about 5 hours late night doing Mudflood dives into the research and discussions, and we're talking about everything from mud flood to spirituality, a little bit of everything, flat earth, all kinds of topics come up, and we've been having a lot of fun. So check us out on Boston Ray's channel, and I hope to see you there, and we hope to do good things with that, and we're trying to get old Boston Ray built up and make him another one of our, you know, wonderful channels that we can go to and learn things and enjoy and build our community. So anyways, that being said, Beagle, roll them credits. Let's go mudding. Watch Palace, World's Fair, San Francisco, California, 1915. This is just a strange photograph. I don't know. Uncle Sam here holding a watch. And a whole bunch of giant Uncle Sams, which I find is interesting. Let's see, Panama Pacific International Exposition, 1915, San Francisco is what it says on there. It's just a strange picture. That's a pretty light. That's cool. It's like a reverse teardrop or upside down teardrop. And this looks horse shitty here. These look really well made. I don't know, it's just very weird. Why do we have a dollar sign? That's interesting. On both sides. Watch Palace. Maybe your antennas. That's strange. Here we got Kansas City, Missouri. That's just a picture I found. I thought it was interesting. Kind of looks vanilla sky there. Just beautiful architecture. And definitely got mud flood windows going down below. I mean, what would make you want to build your home like this? We don't do it today. Well, what make you do it back then? You wouldn't. You really wouldn't. There's just really no excuse that makes that make sense. You know, it snows, it rains, it floods, it's going to be in your home. Retarded. I don't know where this is from, but I believe it's from Kansas City, Missouri also, and I believe it's the same area. Found the two pictures at the same time. Just look how deep that is. It's just crazy. That looks vanilla sky too. What we got going on back here? Not a very good photograph, but it's interesting. It gives an idea of kind of what it was like. Look at that finial. Little ether finials up there. Just interesting. We got 1921 Margaret Gorman in Birmingham car, whose reptilian body
has an alligator finish. In 1921, Margaret was both the first Miss Washington, D.C. and the first Miss America. So this is the first Miss America. Okay. She looks like she's having the time of her life. In her reptoid car. Reptoid car. Phoenician. That's a beautiful light. Phoenician shell. Phoenician wave. Possibly Taurus. Possibly both. And of course, you know, the big ass penis statue. Gotta have that. Otherwise known as the Ether Tower. And we got big old big ass buildings in the background. And they're prettier than the girl. Just saying. What are those hard tires? Interesting. Anyways, we got across the waiting room from the Logia, Pennsylvania station, New York, New York, between 1900 and 1920. Across the waiting room from the Logia. Logia. I don't know what the Logia is. Anywho, I believe this is technology here. All right. Sorry about that. Phone beeping in. That's a famous Mudflood researcher texting me. We'll get back to him. Anywho, Torsfield. That's pretty. Simple yet elegant. This pavement light right there. Ether lights. Who's the statue? Alexander Johnston Cassatt, president. I can't read the rest of it. Somebody that nobody cares about. Dining room. Okay, got some writing down here. Lunch room. Wait, we have a dining room and a lunch room. Okay. All right. Okay. Let's see what's called. Oh. We got four lines for the four instead of the four and the V. The one line and a V. That's interesting. A lot of talk about that these days. I don't know what the deal is with that. Why do we have a lunch room and a dining room? That's odd. Okay, Altman Building, New York, 1906. You got your ether antenna, mercury ball on top. Just so elegant and just perfect. In 1906, just perfection. Come on. I mean, do you really, like, you think about what you think 1904 was like? 1906, excuse me. 1906, do you, it could be a Taurus field. Hard to say. Three eyes, maybe? I don't know. That's really odd. I don't know what that symbol is. But, I mean, if you think about what your vision of 1906 is, there's Fred. Fred is the horse that built America, in case you're unaware and uninformed. And, you know, if you want to know how this brick got into town, the official story is that at some point, Fred did that. And his, you know, buddies. So just imagine this big-ass building shipping in brick by brick via this little fella. Just saying. Check that out. My phone is going nuts tonight. I'm sorry. Let's see. More horse fields. There's pavement light in case you need some of that. Pavement light is cover up for the mud flood. That is glass sidewalk that allows light down into the basements. It has prisms on the bottom and it shoots at a 90 degree angle into the back in there. Look at that pane of glass right there. That is huge. That's a big, big piece of glass. There is a sub-basement sprinkler system hookup, and basically the fire department would come and they'd hook up to this and it would have a sign on there that says sub-basement or basement or sub-basement, excuse me. And they would hook up and they would have sprinkler systems in the basement. I actually have a video of one of those. I'll be breaking out at some point. But good things come to those that wait. I think we built these boxes that these little, I call them outcroppings, but I don't know what they're actually called, but I believe here's another one. I believe we added those in order to, because the doors were too big. Look how large that is. Come on. We're going to use that as a door, you know, that size. Come on. So we had to make the door smaller, and then they thought, well, you know, we can add little roof covered roofs here so that people, when they're coming up, they can get out of their carriage, blah, blah, blah. All makes, you know, really good sense, except the fact that it's a cover-up. It's like pavement light. Old world fire hydrant, I believe fire hydrants are old world. Old arc lights. There's drop-ins to underground right there and there. About, oh wait, we'll go over here. Boss man, boss man. Wonder what they got going here. It's kind of weird. Got a big ass drop in an underground right here. This ground level here. Well, no, this is ground level. Then they got a stair going up. I don't know. That's really weird. Got a big ass hole here. That's interesting. Let's look over here, we'll see what's going on. Okay, arched windows, another ether antenna, ladder lean. Okay, I think that's about it for that. Anthem, I'm not pronouncing it right, Boston, Massachusetts, 1906. Okay, this is in Austin Ray's neighborhood, so maybe he can go check this out for us. That's pretty wrought iron right there. That right there is just plain dangerous. I mean, you talk about somebody pissing you off and you just take care of them. No problem. Here, I got something for you. There's a stairs down into the underground right there. Probably a door right there. Another drop in there. The coin there. Keystones. Could be considered a circumpunct symbol for the creator. I'm not sure what to call that. Taurus fields. There's a chimney that we added. You can definitely tell our work from the old world work. Pretty simple once you see it side by side. Wow, look at that. Brick, brick, brick. Taurus field in the wrought iron there. It's weird. I don't know what that is. Kind of looks like a library. Okay, I think that's about. Something's weird. Something's missing there, it looks like. Okay, we got Atlantic City, New Jersey. Bathers between 1900 and 1910. Bathers. Well, I don't know how y'all wash your ass, but when I wash my ass, I generally like to get nudie. These people are not bathers. These people are tourists that are wearing old underwear. I don't know. Why would you dress like this to go to the beach? Just, I don't know. Why would you wear so many clothes that you're gonna, if you got in the water, you're gonna drown? You got so many clothes on. What's up with this dude? Did he get knocked in the eye? Would you smart off to that fella right there? Like he whooped your ass. Brady's Bass. I wonder if people actually just went out there and washed their ass. I don't know. There's the Marlboro Hotel back there in the background. That's their antenna back there. That Marlboro Hotel, boy, they had to get rid of that sucker. They couldn't be having something like this around today. No way. Mm-mm. That's probably part of wind catchers right here. Diamond symbology. I mean, they had to get rid of that thing. It was too pretty. Probably got rid of this one, too. Big old ether finials. Just amazing. And this is at the beach. Between 1900 and 1910. What is up with you people? I mean, you look like you ain't never seen a camera in your life. Clock. Can't read it. Okay, we got Baltimore Fire of 1904, general view of South Baltimore. And I mean, this looks just like any other Dew attack. Pick a city that they burn down, and you know, arched windows, and there's that old world joist inserts in the brick walls. I believe that's a sign of the old world. Arched doors. Look how thick that brick is. How many courses of brick is that? Look at that. Wow. Look at that butte. Ether finial up there, ether antennas all over. What a cool world. Some of these cities were just too pretty. They had to burn them down. Or do whatever they did to them. I don't know if they burned them, I guess. I don't know what the hell happened here. I just don't think fire is how this was done. For the most part. I think there's another factor involved. Boston Normal and Girls Latin School. Boston, Massachusetts. Between 1900 and 1920. That's weird lines in the ground. Of course, we've got Mudflood Winders. That's like almost standard issue. Like if you build your building prior to 1942, you have to have Mudflood Windows. It's like an architectural, you know, inspection thing. In order to get your building, you know, inspected and approved, you have to have Mudflood Windows. Mr. Contractor comes in there and approves that. He says, yes, you have Mudflood Winders. Your building is approved. Eagle representing the Phoenix and Mercury. Got the dripping fruit. Got an unscrubbed cartouche. And, yes, cartouches are where the word cartouche comes from, the Egyptian idea of a cartouche. But if you search the word cartouche, do a Google search of cartouche, you will find Egyptian cartouches. But if you search cartouche architecture or cartouche design, you will come up with architectural cartouches. So yes, cartouches are what these are called. Just saying, gotta do your research. Girls Latin school. Why are they learning Latin? I mean, I don't know, it's kind of weird. Let thy life be sincere. And why is it not in Latin? You know, Latin, it's such a cool language. I wish I could have learned Latin, because Latin is really, really cool. I think the elite teach you Latin because I think Latin is an old world language. And they had to get rid of it. That looks like the four lines too on that clock. Very interesting. Hello, Ether Finial. Producing any energy today? I imagine you are. So these cartouches, Boston Normals School. That's odd. Normals. So we got the Normals School and Girls Latin School. Wonder what the difference between the normal and the... That's weird. Okay, I don't know the answer to that. A lot of brick there. Need to get a count on that brick. Get that all added up. But this is an unscrubbed cartouche and unscrubbed cartouche. When they had a cartouche that had something on it they didn't want shown, they would just chisel it off. And that's why you see so many of them that are round. And if you think about it, see, this is the thing. You got to think about things in a different way. You got to take the telescope, flip it upside down, and look down the other end, you know? And what you're going to see is you're going to see, wait a minute, you got all these cartouches with nothing on them. But then if you think about it, well, of course they should have had something on them. Why would they not have something on them? They look stupid without anything on them. They look, you know, plain and boring and unfinished. So in that case, you know, that's not how you know that they're not right. Moving on. And we got Buffalo, New York, post office between 1900 and 1920. And let's see what we got. Arched winders. Taurus fields. That's interesting. Coal hole cover there. That's a flat earth asterisk, which is the symbol for flat earth. And that the way you get that is you mirror this on the bottom. You don't need both sides. You just need the one side in order to have the symbol. Although most of the time you do see both sides. And they like to act like this is a sun symbol. That's not the sun symbol. That's a flat earth asterisk. That's me opinion. That's an interesting Taurus there. This is just so excessive right here. You got that wrought iron right there. Mercury ball antenna. Wow, check out the detail. Got a finial on top of a water tower. Smokestack that's not a smokestack. Another ether antenna over there. Ether finials up here. Ether fencing. Got a fractal business going on here with a wind catcher up here. Eagles representing the Mercury and the Phoenix. Gargoyles. Cool. That's pretty. I bet that's got some juice sucking capabilities. Get the ether out there. Out the atmosphere. Ether antenna. There's your ether finial. That's a beautiful structure. Not a very... This picture's not... The quality's... It's overexposed, but it's still pretty good for quality. Old ether lights that they changed to gas lights. Look at that drop down into the mudflood. Mudflood winders. Got more drop down over here. You can't see it too good. Look at the size of those doors. You got the three doors again. Cars stop here as opposed to somewhere else. Mudflood winders. Mudflood drop in here with mudflood winders going below ground, because that makes sense. More mudflood winders. More mudflood winders. More mudflood winders. Here we go. Here we go. Got drop down there. Look how big them doors are. That's just huge. Another drop in. Got a drop in right here on this building. Get kind of shaded here, can't see too good. It's a hell of a building there. Got their antennas, got their fencing. Got their finials all the way. Okay. Very interesting. Okay. Another Buffalo, New York, 1905, Lafayette Square. And of course, we have a big ass obelisk in the middle of a city because we're ancient Rome, I suppose. No. We are gathering free energy and distributing it throughout the city, and we added horseshit Civil War crap to these things. And I bet you dollars to donuts at one time they had lights on the four corners here. I believe the light said, oh, a cannon that's not a cannon. How about that? Isn't that interesting? That's cool how that must have been some wind in the trees blowing. So it went out of focus. That's cool. Of course, you know, there's Fred right there. Fred is supersonic Fred right now. Fred is getting the bricks delivered. Because, you know, that's how all this shit got here is, you know, bricks. And a world fire hydrant. Let's see. Got mudflow winders back here with big ass arches. Moving vans. Okay. And this, where this is something I learned, that where the buildings have this look to them, this is a darkroom photographic technique that makes the buildings look like that. I don't know how it's done, but that's what it is. Mudflood winders. Look how big that damn wind is right there. Arched winders. Got a clock. Clocks is expensive. That's a pretty building. That's pretty too. Cartouches all across the top look like they're scrubbed. Lafayette Hotel fireproof. Okay. Alright. Big ass arch winds. That's boss man right there. He's there having a meeting of the boss man's right there. Interesting. Might be a call box. I don't know. I wonder if this is a third rail system. No, it's two rail. Okay. Two rail. La da 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 da. What do we got? We got horseshit awnings, of course. Look at the size of those freaking winders. That is a proper winder. Here's some of those winders. These are on a swivel. I believe that's part of a wind catching system. And usually I have the wind catcher shown at the end of my videos. It's not going to be in there tonight. I didn't put it in there this week. Ether antenna. Got your urns. Probably capacitors. The bricks were where they stored the energy. Because bricks are batteries. Look it up. Do your research. Okay, I'm moving on. Calhoun Monument, Charleston, South Carolina, between 1890 and 1910. Boss Band. Boss Kids. I bet you it was a light on all four corners here at one time back in the day. Some sort of horseshit there. Big ass obelisk, some jackass on top. We obviously took something off the top there and added that. Check out that ether finial. Portholes. Was it the Maltese cross? Or it could be considered a Templar cross too. That's an interesting symbol. Oh, there's the Mitsubishi symbol. And I'm going from memory, but I believe this symbol also represents the Pleiades, if I'm not mistaken. If my memory serves. Oh, check out that fountain back there. Wow, that's pretty cool. Look, the water's coming out right here. I've never seen a fountain like that. That's old world tech right there. How cool is that? Nice. There's the three doors. Got your one bigger than the other three. Other two, excuse me. Rose window. And I heard a theory today that there was no glass in the rose windows, and I'm not on board with that yet. I don't see any evidence for that, but my thoughts at this time are that they rearranged the glass so that it inactivated it. It didn't work like it used to, and they added these horseshit religious narratives into them. But if I see evidence that there was no glass in them, then you know that'll be different. But if you know anything about how hard it is to get this glass in here, these things just didn't just pop up there. It is a very hard process to create stained glass, and it is not just throwing glass randomly in there. It's I don't even want to get into it, but it if you do research on stained glass, you'll learn a lot of things that you didn't know. But stained glass is very, very complicated stuff. Very complicated. Anyways, moving on. Cambridge, Massachusetts, Harvard University Yard and Library between 1913-1920. So Boston Ray, get busy on this. Go get you some shots here of that Mudflood winder. And that's part of the wind catcher system right there for the movement of the air. There's that three circle symbol. I don't know what that's called. That has a tarp over it. That's odd. Might have a bad roof or something. Mudflood winders right there. There's your finial. Looks like it's mirror image here. Interesting. Kind of looks like something's supposed to be inside there. I don't know. Some sort of symbol there. Back out so I can see. Okay. Got your flat earth asterisk right there. You got your vertical, your horizontal, and your X representing your torus. Your vertical represents your north-south magnetic poles, and your horizontal represents your flat earth plane. Big ass door. Okay. And moving on. Canal Street in New Orleans, circa 1910. Large building is the Mason. Okay. Blanquet department store. M-A-I-S-O-N. Mason. Myosin. I'm probably butchering that. I am not a wordsmith. Are you cold? I'm just saying. And there's Fred. Hey, Fred. Everybody say hello to Fred. Fred enjoys the comments. Well, I think people show up just for Fred. Pretty much. That's okay. I don't mind. I'm not offended. Fred worked hard for where he is. His credibility. Look at that wrought iron work. Smart clothes. Okay. Now, what do we know about smart things like smartphones and smart meters and smart this and smart that? Ether antenna. What do we know about smart when they put that in the title? What does that tell you? Da, 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 da. That's pretty. Bellman's. You know, it's interesting. This lighting here reminded me of something, a comment I heard. I got this comment several times in the last week or two about talking about the old world lighting of and how I was talking about Luna Park and the lighting and the knob and tube lighting and how it was used with incandescent bulbs. And I had several comments about how they would be asking about completely different structures and completely different parts of the world, like it has anything to do with what I was talking about. And I don't know why people do that. They'll say, I'll be talking about apples, and they'll start talking about oranges, and then wonder and then questioning why I'm not agreeing with them. Was because you're talking about fucking oranges and I'm talking about apples, you know. I mean, use your head, people. I mean, when I say something about Luna Park, I'm not talking about, you know, China, you know. And I'm serious, this is literally what I heard this past week. Well, it wasn't China, it was a whole different country, but I literally heard, well, because I see something in China and it doesn't look like it has lights on it, then, you know, they're referring to what I'm saying about Luna Park in Coney Island. I mean, what are you talking about? If you're going to talk about something, talk about that structure, that thing, that place, that location. Don't talk about, if I'm talking about one thing, don't be talking about another. What are you talking about? People got their head up their ass, I swear they do. Arclight. Sorry, started my little rant. I get some of the frustration that some of these researchers bring out in me. I have a very limited capability to deal with stupid, and so when I hear stupid, I get really aggravated, and I just have to do the smackdown. I just Tartarian lions. I just have very limited capacity for stupid. Tartarian lines all over the place. Excuse my rant. You just wouldn't believe some of the ridiculousness I get from the community. A lot of it's behind the scenes that you guys don't even see. It's just ridiculous. I don't know. Anyways, ether antenna. That is a pretty building right there. That sucker has him a big old ring in his mouth. Horseshit writing on the windows. That makes sense. You're going to build this beautiful building and you'll put horseshit writing all over it. That's genius level. No, my point is, if we're talking about apples, let's talk about apples. Let's not talk about apples and then compare the oranges to them. Okay, they're two different things. Okay, we need to take. I don't want to have a conversation about bowler hats, and then you start talking about, you know, top hats. Okay, yes, they're both hats. No shit. But if I'm talking about bowler hats, talk about bowler hats. You know what I'm saying? Don't compare. Don't act like, well, you know, a top hat is better than a bowler hat when I'm talking about bowler hats. You know what I mean? The internet is stupid. It really is. Chicago, Illinois State, street south from Lake Street between 1890 and 1910. 1890, jeez. There's Fred. He is so tired. He needs a carrot. Probably a coal hole cover there. There's the entrance to the underground right there. That's pavement light. In case you need that, lady in uniform. Boater hat. Pavement light right there. Old world fire hydrant. Horseshit awnings. Big ass door. Look at that arch. I mean, come on. Why would you build like that? Why would you spend the time and effort and money to build like that? Why? Because these people care. These people don't care. Look at them. Only thing this woman right here cares about is how her hair looks. Okay? That's all she cares about. Okay? The only thing you know this fella cares about, well, we know what he cares about. I'm just saying. He don't care about this damn building. I mean, I do. I think it's beautiful. But, I mean, in the time frame, do you really think these people are looking up these damn buildings? Hell no. They're looking for a meal. You know? There's Pooper Scooper, man. But, I mean, that's a third rail system right there. So, it's getting its electricity from underneath. How about that? Oh, okay. Wait a minute. Hold on now. Correction. This one's getting it from above. But this is the old system, which is still in place, which it may still be working on other trolleys. That's interesting. I wonder if we can find one. But that is a third rail system. So it's either the cable system or the conduit system. Ah, it's out of use. Look, we've solved the mystery. It's been taken out right here. That's interesting. What the hell's going on there? Is that taken out? Is that been removed? Or is that... Oh, that's weird. Is it anywhere else? That's the only line that has it. It's got two tracks. That's the only one that has the third line. Oh, how weird's that? Interesting. I don't know the answer to that. Maybe it's just they hadn't removed it yet. Got a buffet. I used to love a buffet when I was young. Of course, I could eat half the buffet at the time. I can't eat too much now. I ain't like a ether antenna up here, ether antenna. I don't know. I can't eat like I used to. That's a good thing. I don't know. Ether antennas. A lot of smog. That's a busy place. Look how this road has got that bump in the road right there. How odd is that? Why did they not grade that? Come on. Remember, they raised Chicago. Remember that? Do you think... Okay, think about this. This building right here, does that look like it's been raised? You really think they raised that building? I'll be honest with you. I don't believe they raised Chicago. I think that's a horseshit narrative. I do not see the evidence of that. Now, that's just an opinion right now, and I haven't done the deep research in it. But my thinking is that they came up with this narrative and covered it over and viaducted it. And covered it in pavement lights and called it a day. And came up with this narrative that, yeah, they jack-screwed all these buildings up. I don't believe it. Cincinnati, 1910. Mercantile Library Building, Walnut Street. Okay. Can't see what's going on down there. Dry cleaning. Okay. Got something going on there. That's pavement light right there. And there. There's Fred and Wilbur. They're the horse that built America and his cousin. More pavement light right there. Let's see. Boston Ray was out doing some research filming today, and he looked down and he was standing on pavement light. He had no idea. He was like, oh my God. He was in Cambridge, Massachusetts, and found pavement light. Got good video of it too. Good job, Ray. And got a underground here. If you see, if you got the eyes to see, got a finial there, fence there. Excuse me. Da 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 da. Big old arch windows. Let's get back down here. There's Pooper Scooper Man's cart, in case you're a Pooper Scooper Man follower, Mecca. Look how dirty them streets are. Gibson. Okay, I don't think they're going to show us nothing. This is a, damn, this is a tall picture. Oh, all the way up to the top. Good grief. Oh, hello. They go arch windows, brick, brick, brick. I believe this is a Phoenician symbol. Reminds me of a wave. That is pretty. Very interesting. Look at that facading. This is probably the metal facade here. That's what that looks like. I do's believe. Yep. Bismarck. Oh, let's go over here and look. Oh. What you gonna show us? Got their antenna there, got their antenna and ether fencing, excuse me. Okay. Got circa 1904, Trinity Church, Toledo, Ohio, at the intersection of Adams and St. Clair Street. There's Pooper Scooper Man right there in foreground. That's Boss Man. Right there, Boss Man. Women in uniform. You tell me that in a uniform. Shoot. Very nice. Everybody's doing well in the chat. Having fun. Being a community. Learning together, exchanging ideas, arc lights, ether fencing, ladder lean. Oh, okay, this fella's serious. Oh, wow, look at them mudflood winters down there. Them are pretty. Is that sad that I can look at a mudflood winter and call it purdy? I tell you, what a world. Well, I never thought that I would ever be this interested in architecture. I really didn't. I was interested in pretty girls now, but I never thought I'd be interested in architecture. But I guess they're kind of, they got, you know, pyramid symbology. I guess they got a lot in common. They're both pretty. And we got Coney Island as seen from an army plane in 1920. It's not the clearest photograph, but it's still interesting nonetheless because you get to see kind of a layout of what Coney Island was like, which is neat. There's the entrance. I believe, if I'm not mistaken, this is, you know, the, I think, you know, we've got many pictures and I believe some film of the entrance there of Luna Park. Not exactly sure where Dreamland is. There's the famous tower in the center. The one that's lit up with the, not, you know, well, it's all knob and tube lighting with incandescent lights, the entire facility. I think I've proved that now. And no, I'm not talking about any other facility in the entire world, including India. Jeez. Or Japan, or France, or Russia. I'm not talking about anywhere but Luna Park, okay? Now, if you hear me talking about somewhere else, then I'm talking about that other place. We can't generalize things. If I say something about this tower right here, it doesn't mean I'm talking about something on the other side of the world. Okay? And I, why you would ever insert that thought into the ether is pure retardation. Just saying. Not the clearest picture in the world, but it's interesting to see the layout. And like I said, as always, pictures are in the description. And you can go and do your own research. Courthouse, New Orleans, Louisiana, between 1909 and 1920. Ghost man. Hello. Keep off grass. Can you not read, little boy? Obviously. Got, that is photoshopping right there. 100%. I don't know what they're photoshopping. It kind, you know what that looks like? I bet. And I could be wrong. But I think that that is one of those cleats on a foam pole. And it's just in the shot, and the foam pole is over here, and this is a cleat sticking out from the foam pole. It's just a guess. It's exactly what that looks like. Ether lights. Big old arch doorways and windows, and got an unscrubbed cartouche there. Interesting. Looks like a lion there, Tartarian lion. Scrubbed cartouche there and there. See how stupid they look scrubbed? They look like, I mean, it's like, what's the point? Why did you go through all this elaborate detail in order to put nothing in the middle? I mean, once you see it, it's like, oh, yeah, okay. I've had my head up my ass. I get it now. Okay, that's why it was so dark. My head was up my ass, literally. Check that out. Purdy. Ether antenna. There's that circle. See this circle a lot. Taurus fields. Very nice. I know some people from Louisiana, from New Orleans. I bet they would enjoy seeing this picture. Along with any other Louisiana related objects. We got a stone road. Well, let's call it cobblestone road. And again, I do not believe in a theory that this is brick. That is way too big to be brick, and brick doesn't usually get cut in triangles either. So again, I'm not a fan of that theory. I'm hearing a lot of wacky theories these days. And it's wonderful to have a theory. It's a wonderful thing to have a theory and say, what if? That's great. I love that. I love to say what if. I love to speculate and say, what if? Blah, 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 blah. Okay. So you give out your theory. But then the thing is that a lot of times people don't put any thought into the theory. There's no thought into the actual what would actually happen if that was the way it was. Like if that was true. It's just the theory. There's no thought behind the theory. It's like ash coming down and raining down. These roofs cannot handle a whole shit ton of brick ash coming down. The weight would collapse the roofs. It just, and then the buildings would be just absolutely decimated from this ash. Not to mention the fact that what we see is not even. We see angled roads, angled flows of mud. We do not see even drops of ash. But see, people don't think about that. They just have these theories, and they put them out, and they, you know, and then people latch onto them because they're looking for answers, you know, and they think, oh my God, here's an answer. They latch onto it like it's a titty, you know, and they just suck that titty. And they don't put any thought into how bad that milk could be. Just saying. Moving on. And we got Detroit, Michigan, 1912 Hotel Pontchartrain Soldiers and Sailors Monument also. And let's go down and see what's going on. Got Fred and Wilbur working, getting the job done, being the horses that build America. Got woman in uniform. More women in uniform. Boss man. That dude's weird looking. A tall dude. Old world fire hydrant. Flat earth asterisk. In case you need to know what kind of earth you're on, they will let you know at every turn. Well, we turn and, well, they let you know again. Because the flat earth asterisk is the symbol for the flat earth. Misfit. Odd name. See how we got stairs going up here. Interesting. Because we can't figure out how to put the door on the ground level. And we did the little insert door here. A little outcrop door. Old car. Punch train. A porthole here and here. Possibly part of a wind catcher system. Got our three doors. Looks like Phoenician faces there. It looks like it could be pavement light right there on the front. Hard to tell though. See what we're gonna find. What are you up to there? Interesting. Eagle, eagle representing the Phoenix and Mercury, and you got your horseshoe Civil War narrative. Do not believe in the Civil War anymore personally. I've thrown that whole narrative out the window, along with the Revolutionary War. American Revolutionary War, I should say. Oops. And let's see, what are we gonna find? You know, I got a feeling that there was a obelisk on top of this sucker, and they added the statue up here. I bet there was an obelisk on top of this at one time, and they knocked it down, or it fell down in the takeover. Yep, I do believe. I see this quite often. And they don't look, they look like they should have an obelisk on them. They really do. Ether antenna with Mercury balls. Very nice, very nice. That's a lot of brick. We need to get count on all this brick now. Who's making all this brick? Where are they making all this brick? How are they putting out this much brick and moving this much brick in the time frame they said that they used this much brick? Scrub cartouches on the corner there. More flat earth asterisks in case you forgot where you were. And it kind of looks like that something got removed off of here. This could be part of a wind catcher system here. It looks like something was removed off the top of that building. To me. It's an opinion. Everybody's got one. That's mine. Capacitors. Alrighty. East Denver Turner Hall, headquarters of the 31st Bundstumfest. What? Bundenstumfest. I am butchering that. I ain't gonna try to read that. Denver, Colorado. Whoa. Wowza. That big ass door. Something underground there. Coal hole cover there. You got a stairs going down right here. Going into the underground. Because that makes sense. Yeah. We designed that building to do that. Because, well, yeah. That made sense. Porthole. Ether finial there. Ether antenna. Ether finial. 889. So, I-889. Turner Hall. Okay. Wait. Okay, the note says Turner Hall. Does that look like it says Turn Hall or Turner Hall? I don't know. Whatever. It's odd. Wish this picture was clearer. Some writing here I can't read. Shoot. Hiding stuff from us. Mile High. Oh, it's in Denver, Colorado. What is that? Wait a minute, get back. Look at that. Got a phone pole here and it disappears. That's Photoshop. And look how it goes into this. Looks like spray paint. Like you're using in Microsoft Paint. So it looks like they did the whole picture. You know, why are they photoshopping these photographs, you know? You have to wonder that. What is the... That's a transom with prism glass in it. I don't know. Why are they photoshopping all these pictures? 1908. Three New York Brooklyn bridges from Brooklyn. Okay, so there's one, two, where's the third one? There's one bridge. Oh, there's another bridge. Not being finished. It's not done yet. Another bridge. Smokestacks that ain't smokestacks all over the place. I don't know what smokestacks were. Heard they were water towers. I don't know. Maybe. I don't know. Underground. Underground all through there. Look at that. All that underground. You know, it's funny how, you know, look back in these old photographs and how you see underground entrances and, you know, everywhere. They're just all over the place. And then today they're gone. And dropping it underground right there, Mudflood winters. I mean, you know, if we needed these, you know, fancy dancy underground areas, why are they not there today? For the most part, I mean, there's still some there. They, you know, stuff like brownstone, stuff like that. But for the most part, they're trying to, you know, get away from that. You know, they don't build like that today. And they're not stupid anymore. They weren't stupid to begin with. They just didn't build that. That big ass door. big ass archway. New York City. That building's cool. So many questions. $2 Boston. It's interesting. I wonder what that means. Those are weird clouds. Look at that. Huh. That line right there. That looks really odd, right? I don't know. This is Coney Island. This is the Dreamland fire when they blew Dreamland up. So I just thought it was interesting. You've got a flat earth asterisk right on the top. That was just an interesting photograph. And also, I thought this was interesting. You notice how this guy here, this guy here, this guy here, this kid, maybe this police officer, how they're stepping on the hose. Even this guy. They're all stepping on the hose. Now, when I first saw this photograph, it didn't hit me, but then I was like, you know what? They're adding pressure to the line, trying to squeeze the pressure to make it more pressurized. That's what they're doing. Because, I mean, look how serious they are. Interesting, huh? And see, this is what I'm wondering, if that's the water line and it's... that's the water flowing and it's lost pressure. Because see, this one has pressure. I don't know, it's just something interesting. I don't know. Jefferson Market, New York, 1905. And that is just something else. Look at these clouds. I mean, we don't even have clouds like that anymore. Everything's an old chemtrail. They don't even let us have a damn cloud now. We can't go to a store without a damn face diaper on, and we can't even have clouds. What can we have? When are we going to take this world back? Windcatcher, diamond symbology. I'm just wondering. Etherfennial. You know, some places that'd be called a church. Just saying. There's Fred. Fred's a horse built America, in case you didn't know. I got another picture I'm going to show you. It's going to show this up close, clear. So we'll look at that in a minute. So I don't want you to think I forgot it. La-di-da-di-da-di-da. Look at all the goods. Trolleys everywhere. Should just call us Trolley World. Big ass door. Mudflood landers. I mean, in other places, this would be called a church. No doubt. Got your EL, elevated train. Got their antenna back here. It's just, that's a pretty building. What got going here? Maybe a water fountain? I don't know. Okay, and then we got a closer up picture here. Old Antiquitec light here, which has been converted to gas. But look at this dude. His job is to stand here and guard this little gate here so you go down into the Mudflood. Interesting, right? There's Fred. Hey, Fred. Fred's a horse built America, in case we're unaware and uninformed. I'm just saying. Old world fire hydrant. Anyways, New York City, Fifth Avenue, a White Wing Parade, New York Street Cleaners, 1913. And this literally is a pooper scooper man parade. These are the actual New York City pooper scoopers. And they're in a parade. Look at those guys. I think they go to China. Look, I mean, these people are like straight up. There's Fred. Fred's back here. Make sure his parade's going over good. Fred does it all. Delivers all the bricks, delivers all the wood, delivers all the food, delivers all the people, delivers everything. Fred is tired. Fred is overworked. Fred needs a raise. Fred for president. Got arc lights right here. But yeah, this is a pooper scooper parade. Street cleaners, well, that's pooper scoopers. That's what they do. And they wore these little white suits with little white penis caps. That is a literal pooper scooper parade in 1913. New York, 1905 Broadway, Times Building. Broadway and Times Building. One Times Square. Okie dokie. Well, there's pavement light in case you need some of that. Hello, Dandy. That's Boss Man. More pavement light here in case you need some of that, you know. Fill out your day. Make you feel better that you've seen some pavement light. How in the hell I'm the one that figured out pavement light is just dumbfounding to me. There's a flat earth asterisk in case you need one of them. I mean, I it's cool to be, you know, able to provide, to add something original to the research. I think I've added a couple things of that are new to the research. Actually, there's more things that I've added to this research, Mudflood research, than people realize, because I've given a lot of my ideas away to other people that I have not exactly got all the credit that, you know, was there. But that's okay. Live and learn. But, you know, pavement light is one that I definitely have retained. And it's just, you know, it's really cool to be able to add something special to the research. There's a Mudflood drop in there. But I think, and you know, I'm not even reaching the masses yet. I mean, most people still don't know what the hell pavement light is. And if they do know what pavement light is, it hasn't really dawned on them how important pavement light is. It's like, you know, pavement light is the knife wound. You know, right where the building meets the mud is where the pavement light is. That's why it's so important, because it's the connection between the old world and the new. Portholes all the way across the sucker. Ether lights all the way across. Yeah, flag that shouldn't be there on ether antennas. But no, I have to say I'm proud of the pavement light thing. That's really cool. So I hope that everyone can learn about them. I'm trying to get the word out. Ether antenna with horseshit flag on it. But ether antenna, mercury balls. Arched winders. That's very pretty work. Wow. That's very nice brickwork. Can't figure out what that thing is. That's weird. What? I don't know. It's very strange. This dude's just freaking me out sitting on the front of this thing like that. There's a touring car. These idiots would get on these touring cars and they would go around the city taking tours of the city. To me, that's odd. Look at that thing. Oh. I love the juxtaposition between the old world, you know, transportation and the new world. That's really cool. Subway entrance right there. Very interesting. Here's just a little something I threw in there. I ain't going to try to pronounce this. I believe this isn't Russia. But I'm not mistaken. That is Russian writing. Where in Russia? I don't know. Would have to ask Philip Drusdenin. He would know. I just thought it was, you know, cool. I ran across it. Every now and then I'll throw in something out of the United States just to... That's Fred, by the way. Fred and Wilbur. I mean, they're working, you know, for the Russians. Good for them. So anyways, I just thought this was, you know, cool picture. How everything's so large in Russia. It's amazing. Wind catcher. I would love to go to Russia. So cool. Wind catcher. Yeah, Russia's something else. Very cool. Alright, moving on. And we got Statuary Hall, U.S. Capitol, circa 1908. Oh, that's a nice little checkerboard pattern on the floor. Ghost people. Da-da-da-da. And some kind of horseshit narrative statues around here. I don't believe any of this crap. Blah, blah, blah. Big old columns with Tauruses on them, of course. And this looks... This right here reminds me of the fascists. This could be the Sub Rosa. Meaning what stays here... Said here stays here. Keep your mouth shut. That's an interesting... Candelabra, maybe? I don't know. That's weird. Looks like a Phoenician wave. It's a weird statue. Anyways. They got the Corn Palace. Built from 3,500 bushels of ear corn. Mitchell, South Dakota, 1908. And if you've never seen the Corn Palace, it is... As far as I know, still there today. I believe that they... I could be wrong about this, but I think the story goes that they changed the corn on this thing every year. And they redo it. I don't know if that's true, but that's what I have been told. I don't know. But, 1908. And, you got swastikas all over the front here. I think that's very interesting. Diamond symbology. Looks like a four-leaf clover. You know, your onion domes, ether antennas, diamond symbology. But all this is corn, you know. Get your cube. I don't know. Very strange thing. I don't know. It kind of looks like a flat earth asterisk. Hard to tell though. That looks like a Taurus. Look at these people up here. I don't know much about the Corn Palace other than it is covered in corn. Different shades of corn, and they make images on it. I do think that they do change this thing. You know, it's... I guess the corn goes bad. I don't know. Just interesting. And I got Sun Newspaper Building on New York's Park Road, 1914. That's weird. There's Fred. Fred's the horse built America. Doesn't he look tired, wore out? Poor Fred. He worked so hard. A business day with President Wilson, described and illustrated by cartoonist. Okay. The evening sun. International correspondence. Correspondence school. Bankers. Alrighty. Going up, up, up. Looks like a wave coming in, isn't it? Warship fire escapes, we added those. It's that old glass. It's got ripples in the light. The sun. Arc light. Some kind of underground right there. Can't see what's going on, but there's definitely underground there. Tourist fields. Ghost people, ghost horses. A complete novel each week by famous author in the Evening World. See today's Evening World. Evening World. What a weird name. Booths and operators in, operator in arcade. Cigars. Okay. Weird. Arc light. Another arc light. Big ass arch. Another ether, old ether light that's been converted for gas. And we got Washington 1920, Grandals Avenue, 645 Pennsylvania Avenue Southeast. Flat Earth Asterix, this is ventilation into the underground. There's a trap door that goes into the underground. Nice. All this mess on here is bad stuff on the negative, just so you know. Scrubbed cartouche. Phoenician shell. Unscrubbed cartouche right here. Could that be the Sub Rosa? Laurel leaf controls. Grandals. Okay. John Barrymore. That is, I believe, kinfolk of Drew Barrymore, of the Drew Barrymore acting family clan. I do believe. Dangerous to men. What? No. So got the glass covered up on the front here. That's interesting. Why would you put the glass there and then put a horseshit sign up over it? This is an old world symbol. Very popular. Look at that black glasswork. See, I bet that glasswork matches this glasswork up here. I bet that's very pretty. That's part of a wind catcher system there. Scrub scrub cartouche. That's a weird picture. Old wives for new. Okay. That's messed up. It's interesting they have the railing here. Usually when you see railing, there's something going down, but I don't see anything going down, so that's odd. More railing there. I don't know. Kind of weird. Okie dokie. And we got Washington, 1921 or 22, Mayor and Company, the Mayor Furniture Store in the Independent Order of Oddfellows Temple at 419 through 23 7th Street Northwest. They're talking about that building right there, I do believe. Okay, what do we got? Got a trapdoor in an underground, coal hole cover there, coal hole cover there. Let's see. There's the coal delivery. That's how they would get the coal there. This is obviously, at one point they were using the horse. You know, Fred would deliver it originally. Yep. Got their antenna over here. That looks like it's been vanilla skied there, I'd say. What you got? Give us something. I guess that's the dentist. Teeth without plates. Painless extracting guaranteed. Right. Back then, no pain, no high prices. Well, that is certainly not true today. Painless dentist. I'm sorry. I think that's false advertising back then. Scrubbed cartouches. IOOF temple, excuse me. Tartarian lion, scrub cartouches across the front here. There's an ether antenna, mercury ball. There's your lion. And you can see it's vanilla skied also. This is so common now, it's just not even, you know, probably Phoenician shells up here. I mean, it's like almost all the pictures are vanilla skied. Washington DC Moore's Garden Theater, no date. Today the invaders. All right. KB film. Reminds me of KB Toys. Wonder if they have anything to do with each other. That's Boss Man. Invaders. Huh. Looks like they're standing behind a wall or something. They're supposed to be Indians or something? I don't know. That's weird. Arched windows. That's part of a wind catcher system there and there. Thank you. That's cool looking. Weird. Flaw in the negative. It looks vanilla skied as usual. Hard to tell though. I don't know. It's like Venetian shells there. Arc light. Weird little door. There's pavement light right there. Not if there's any more though. No, that's all I see. So that means this whole area here is hollow. That's vaults. Very interesting. Washington DC Center Market Knight Street Wing. Okay. Wing. Fruit and candy. Okay. These old delivery trucks are cool. They really made them cool back then. I don't know. It's kind of interesting. There's some bananas. Been hearing about the banana Mandela effect late recently. It's interesting. Arc light. Fleur de lis, however you want to say it. These windows are cool. I bet those were expensive. Hard to make. That's interesting. It's a fleur de lis with an arrow. I wonder if that's actually considered a fleur de lis because it's not a flower. But it is a representation of the flat earth right there. But I don't know. It's just interesting. I don't know if technically that would be called a fleur de lis. I don't know. Got your eagle on the mercury ball here. That's interesting. On the arc light. Smokestack. That's probably a horseshit chimney we added. Ethervenial. Porthole. Ether antenna. Big door. Okay. Got Washington, D.C., 1915 Bond Building, Washington Herald. It's a wild train track system here. Outcrop door we had to add to it. Same here. Tours field. There's a underground door right there. You got stairs right here going down to it. There's Fred. Fred's the horse that built America. And they like to see him. Pyramid symbology. Scrubbed cartouches. That's pretty. Pyramid. Oh wow, Vesca Pisces. Symbol of the male female energy. Oh, this is definitely vanilla skied. No doubt you can see that right there. Yeah, that's definitely vanilla skied. I don't know why they vanilla skied them, but they sure didn't want you to see the backgrounds. If you think about it, though, it's an easy way to cut out whatever's in the back. That's pretty. You know, you don't, they don't want you to see what's really back there and see how all this connects and see what buildings were there when they weren't supposed to be there. It's easy, just cut them out of the picture. Ether antenna. You know, I mean, it's very easy to, you know, hide the evidence. You know, how did they get away with it? Well, they hid it. they Photoshop things. I mean, you know. Washington, D.C., circa 1920, Gustav Buchholz Occidental Hotel and Restaurant on Pennsylvania Avenue. Okay. I think this is a famous restaurant, if I remember correctly. There's a touring car. It's crazy people. You guys, check out that mud flood. Interesting. Big old door. There's the Occidental right there. AAA. That's beautiful wrought iron work right there. Very nice. Well, I got an unscrubbed cartouche with a W in it. But I tell you what, that looks like it was chiseled into me. I don't think that W was there. I think they had something on there and then they chiseled it out. Because that W just don't... It don't look right to me. It's an opinion. This symbol's all over the place. There's a porthole. See how it opens up? You can maneuver the air in and out. Check out that urn. This big arch right here. Gosh, I'd love to see the blueprints for these things. Ether antenna. There's a drop in an underground back there. See that wrought iron railing there? That's a telltale sign of drop in. And speaking of dropping in, I'm going to do some, coming up, going to do some live shows where we do the Google drop into... wherever you want to go. So I started this on Boston Rays live streams, and coming soon I'm gonna do it on my own channel, and basically you'll just tell me where you want to go and we'll go and go there. And you know, sky's the limit as to where we can go. If I can get there on Google, I don't see any reason why we can't go look at it. You know, if Google will allow us to drop in. But we've had a lot of fun doing that, and I aim to continue that idea, because I've been wanting to do that for a long time and I just hadn't done it. And so I've tried it now. It's tried and true. It works. People like it. And so when the next time I do a live stream, just be aware that that's what we're probably going to do, because that's a hell of a lot of fun. We got Detroit, Michigan, Casino, Belle Isle Park, northeast side between 1908 and 1910. And I've got two pictures of this hotel. This one is when it's open. Got ladies in uniform. Something going on there. Big ass arches. Please keep off grass. You know, that's something you see a lot. Please keep off grass. It's a very interesting thing to see a lot of. Why are we seeing those signs all the time? I think that's interesting. These are interesting. Looks like a porthole, but I'm not sure why it's there. Is there a clock in it? Well, that's interesting. This one has a clock and that one doesn't. And they're exactly the same. That's interesting. I do not know. That's weird. People are all dolled up. Where are you going? How do these people have all this money to dress like this in this day and age? How? This is the same building, Detroit, Michigan, 1907, new casino at Belle Isle Park. This is during construction. Got a moon tower here. Very cool. You got your four arc lights. And that would light up the area. There's your clock. Can't tell if the four is the four dashes or the one dash in the V. And we're getting it painted up because this is, you know, this is what we do. We find stuff and then we paint it. We don't actually build it. There's Mr. Contractor's work shed. Smokestack, name Smokestack. This is definitely a construction site or a site that is being finished off from founding it in the middle of a construction. I believe that a lot of these structures were found in the middle of construction, which made it easy to look like they were being constructed. Because to be sure, Mr. Contractor didn't build that. You know, come on. This looks like it was bigger at one point and we blocked it in. It looked, you know, I don't know. And this is right here is interesting. You got the dirt going up here to these windows, but then you've got, you know, a retaining wall built here. So that means that A, you had to build a retaining wall, and then you brought in the dirt. Or, excuse me, you built the building, then you built the retaining wall, then you brought in the dirt. Okay, and then did you remove the dirt? Remove the retaining wall and then fill this area in with dirt? Or did you leave the retaining wall and put a brick here? Why did you do this? Why did you not leave this flat? And they did the same thing here. And something going on, man, kind of the same thing here. But this right here is kind of dumbfounding to me. Like, you know, why would you do this? Like, if you think of it from a logical angle, why you would build it like this, where you'd obviously have to have this gone in order to build your building, right? So it couldn't have been here when they built the building. And then to get the wall here, to get the dirt here, you had to have the wall here first. So obviously the building came first, then the retaining wall, then the dirt. But then why would you do that? why wouldn't you just put the dirt up against the building after it was built? Or did you build a brick wall here? And if so, why didn't you build the brick wall before you put the dirt in? I mean, it's logic. I mean, there's these strange anomalies that just don't add up. 2 + 2 = 4. I mean, you know, if you're building, in my logical mind, this is not how you build the fucking building. Excuse my French. That's not how you build a bridge either. But it just doesn't, that dog don't hunt me. That's all I'm saying. Anyways, Beagz out.
You. mystery. It's a mystery wrapped in a riddle inside an enigma. Don't you get it?
Say woof again. Say woof again.
I've got one that can see.
Welcome to the underground.
The snozzberries taste like snozzberries.
This is my kung fu, and it is strong.
See you later.